without further ado, would be duplicitous. But in any event, thank you so much for coming tonight. And thank you for cooperating with the confirmation number system, which you could see why we needed it. The co-production with the Edvard Grieg Society is now in a multi-year history, and you know, it's really great for New York, but tonight is going to be a real highlight for our series, and I hope for the Edvard Grieg Society as well. And Per Breivik will talk to you after the intermission. There will be an intermission before the Grieg. So ladies and gentlemen, Anne Schein and Derek Atkins.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
just welcome again from the Musicians Club. It's a little unusual for us to have a crowd like this, but again, I want to thank you for your cooperation. We might have to do this more in the future. Our numbers are growing. Members, I apologize that I had to turn some of your guests away this last week, but normally that doesn't happen, but members are guaranteed a seat here, so we have to save some seats. So put that in the back of your mind if you're thinking of running. There are some small benefits to membership, but you can discuss that with me anytime. And now I'd like to turn over the program to Per Brevik, who is on the board of the Musicians Club. He is also the president of the Greek Society, and he wears many other hats, but today that is his big hat.
Thank you, Ray. Thank you, Ray. And excuse my back. I'm very sorry to have to turn back to you. Next time, I hope you will be up front. So, Ever Greek. He was 15 years old when he traveled from Bergen, Norway to Leipzig, Germany, to study. So in Leipzig, that was the place to study during his time. And it was Mendelssohn conducted the orchestra in Leipzig, and Schumann, we know Schumann's name. So that was more or less a center of music in Europe at that time. So he had 4 years there. After that, he went to Copenhagen, where he continued studying and composing. And he composed a symphony. He was like 18, 20 years old. And the symphony has a story. And I'm going to tell you the story about it and be as brief as I can. So the symphony was performed. And for some reason, he was not very happy about it. So he wrote on the first page of the score, he said, "Must never be performed again." So we're trying to figure out what the reason was for that. One reason that has come up is because there were other very fine composers, Norwegian composers at that time. So he felt he had competition from Johan Svendsen. He wrote several symphony and wonderful music. He's not as well known as Grieg, but nevertheless, his music is beautiful. So is Johan Halvorsen. So he thought that his symphony was not as good as those of Svendsen, must never be performed again. That's what he decided to do. So that symphony, then the material went to the library in Bergen, Norway, and researchers could go there and research it. But for some reason, to make the story very short, the score got out from the library. I'm not sure who did it, who got it, whatever it was, but it ended up in Russia. And suddenly, there was a performance on the Greek symphony in Russia. So when that happened, of course, then in Norway, they had to start doing it also. So since then, it has been performed many times. I have conducted it many times, and there is one specific thing about that symphony is that it has to be interpreted. It's that you can't just give the downbeat and let it go. You really have to interpret the music. Wonderful piece of music. Like Grieg also wrote beautiful songs and other music, but we feel that he should have written more music with larger scales, like a symphony. So we know Grieg as a composer, but during his lifetime, a lot of artists, composers, they were also conductors. And think of Mahler, for instance. Mahler was a conductor number one. People didn't even know about his music so much during his lifetime. As we know, he had summer vacations. He went to his cottage, and that's where he composed his music. With Grieg, he conducted all over Europe, and he carried his music with him. He was enormously successful as a conductor. And the story says that he had conducted an orchestra in Europe, and the audience wouldn't let him go. They kept applauding, and he came out, and in and out, and so he thought, what am I going to do with this? So then he did something very smart. He went backstage, put on his overcoat, went on the stage, took the applause, and the audience got the message, Lambert was going home. So, unfortunately, I haven't been in that situation, but it would be a nice situation to be in. Grieg is known for his harmony, his beautiful harmonies, which you will hear in the next piece. And so, there were European composers whom we know, Debussy and Ravel especially, they attribute their development of harmony much to Grieg. And there was an English composer that I have a quote from him. This is Delius saying, modern French music is simply Grieg plus the prelude to the third act of Tristan. I think that it's fascinating, but also it's extremely descriptive. Grieg was also a writer and a critic. When he was in Leipzig, he saw Tannhäuser 14 times. So you can imagine, he knew Wagner's music. He also was a critic for Norwegian papers. And there was when The Ring was done, he was asked to critique it. And I have read those reviews. It's absolutely fascinating. And it's much deeper than you hear nowadays. So I think that's about it about Grieg. And they tell you he has his own home in Bergen, a Trollhaugen, it's called. And you can still go and visit there, beautiful place. It's a little concert hall and his composer hut where he composed. You can look over at the ocean, not the ocean, at the lakes. And it's a very beautiful place. So that was the Grieg 101. So now we come to the artist. So Derek Atkins is a good friend of the Edward Grieg Society. He has played with them many, many times. And there are so many familiar faces here, both from the Musicians Club and the Grieg Society. So many of you know by now that Derek is our son-in-law. So we are also very pleased then, you know, you probably read the notes. He teaches at Oberlin, he teaches at Juilliard, he teaches at Aspen Music Festival, maybe three of the greatest schools that you can teach in. And so when he is here, he was able to bring his family here. So our daughter Ingrid brought her four children all the way from Ohio this morning. Thank you for coming, Ingrid, and I'm pleased to have you here. So then we have Anne Schein. Anne, are you there? not yet. No. So Anne is also an old friend, or I should say a friend that we have known for a very long time. So she concertized since she was like 18 years old, and she's a good friend of Norway because she played with the Norwegian orchestras. I would say 1950s, 60s maybe. That was a time when I was actually a member of the Bergen Philharmonic in Norway, not in New Jersey, and before I came to this country. And lastly, I will tell you about the page turner for tonight. Many of you, page turner doesn't get much credit, but tonight is very specialized because the page turner is Earl Carlis, and he was a member of the Juilliard String Quartet for many, 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 many years. And also, many of you know that Earl and Anne, they are married for many years. So, this was long enough, I thought. Thank you very much.
Now I can after many trips to Norway, I had a very beloved manager there, Helga Kolbe, who took me when I was 18 and became determined she would send me to every town in Norway. And I fell in love with Norway. Of course, I married a Swede. And then when it got to the days when I got to know my almost husband, and it looked like it was very serious, and I had lost my own mother and father, but Helga became a surrogate mother for me. So I said to her, do you think it's the right thing to do? Do you think that I really should marry this man? He's Swedish, you know. And she said, I'm going to teach you a sentence in Norwegian. And I think I say it, you tell me if it's correct, vi går I giftetanker. We are thinking of wedding thoughts, she said. She said, go for it. That's my page dream.
Thank you. Thank you.
visit our verses and enter them privately. Make sure you don't get fucked out. Thank you very much.